Okay, Charles, what have we learned? And I mean specifically in the context of this Game Theory 2 lesson.
That's a good question. We learned about Iterated Prisoner's Dilemma, which turns out to be cool, and it solves the problem. And we learned about how we can connect Iterated Prisoner's Dilemma to reinforcement learning.
What do you mean?
Through the discount.
Yeah, so I think of that as being the idea of repeated games.
Right. Let's see. What else have we learned? So we learned about Iterated Prisoner's Dilemma, which allowed us to get past this really scary thing with repeated games, connected it with reinforcement learning, with discounting. And then we learned other things, like, for example, I don't remember. What did we learn?
Well, so the connection between Iterated Prisoner's Dilemma and repeated games was the idea that we can actually encourage cooperation. And in fact, there's a whole bunch of new Nash equilibria that appear when you work in repeated games. And that was the concept of the folk theorem.
Right, the folk theorem. So the folk theorem is really cool. And this whole notion of repeated games really seems like a clever way of getting out of what appeared to be limitations in game theory.
Right. Yeah. In particular, by using things like threats.
Right. But only plausible threats.
Right. So that was the next thing we talked about. The idea that an equilibrium could be subgame perfect or not, and if it wasn't, then the threats could be implausible. But in the subgame perfect setting, they're more plausible.
Right. Let's see. And then we learned about minimax Q.
Well, there was one last thing we did on the repeated games, which was the computational folk theorem.
Yes, you're right. So basically what we learned is that Michael Lippmann does cool stuff in game theory.
Or at least he does stuff that he's willing to talk about in a MOOC.
Yes. So that's there's actually a technical term for that, right? MOOC acceptable research.
Oh, I didn't know that.
Mm-hmm.
So all these things are, by virtue of the fact that they showed up in this class, MOOC acceptable.
Exactly.
All right, you're right. Then we switched to stochastic games.
Mm-hmm.
And they generalize MDPs and repeated games.
Mm-hmm.
Anything else?
Well, that particularly got us to minimax Q, and then eventually to Nash Q. But despite the fact that NashQ doesn't work, we ended up in a place of hope.
We end with some hopefulness.
Yeah, and you know, I think that that's actually a lesson for the entire course. That at the end of the day, sometimes it doesn't always work, but there's always hope.
We don't give up, and that's what, how research works. Even when we have impossibility results for things like clustering or multi-agent learning and decision-making, we still keep struggling forward.
And keep learning. And isn't that what's really important? I think so.
It's important for us, and it's important for machines.
Yes, that is beautiful. I feel like we've made it to a good place, Michael. Perhaps we should stop.
Well, it has been delightful getting to talk to everyone, and it's been very fun getting to talk with you, Charles. And thanks to everybody for making this happen.
I agree. And we have one more chance to talk with one another as we wrap up the class, and I look forward to that. So I will see you then, Michael.
Awesome. Do we get to see each other in person for that?
We get to see each other in person for that. That'll be fun.
Yay.
Okay. Well, bye, Michael. I'll see you next time.
Bye. See ya.
Bye-bye.